Welcome to the Idea Space, a podcast devoted to sharing strategies and tools to help you make your dream life possible. I'm your host, Jen Liddy, a teacher turned entrepreneur. It's my mission to help women grow their businesses and get what they want without feeling guilty, overwhelmed, or confused. If you're tired of your ideas spinning around your mind and you really want something more for yourself, you're in the right place. Learn how to create the space to make your ideas a reality. I promise, if I can do this, anyone can. Let's go. Hello there. Welcome to the Idea Space Podcast. I'm your host, Jen Liddy, and this podcast is a place where we create room in your mind and your life to make your swirling ideas a reality. Today, I'm telling you about a story I had. It was a moment that I was really pissed off, but that pissed offedness taught me how to know that what I had to share with the world was really valuable. And I want to tell you the story today because I wonder if you are saying to yourself, everybody can do what I do and it's not very valuable. And I think that what I'll teach you today will help you move forward in that realm. So what I'm going to share with you today happened 2 years ago, but I remember exactly how I felt and exactly where I was sitting. I think it's a lesson that I learned that will help you make a big shift somewhere in your life. So back then, I thought I had a superpower. There was this thing that I loved doing for people, and it was incredible, easy, and fun for me to do it. And because it was so easy and so fun, I always second-guessed myself. I thought, was it really a superpower? I mean, if this is so easy for me to do, will other people pay for it? And this just speaks to a long-standing limiting belief deep inside my mind that I believed for something to be valuable, i.e. for other people to pay for it, it needed to feel like hard work. I had to really work for it. So one breezy May afternoon, the opportunity to test my theory dropped into my lap. So to give you some background, I'm a member of a huge Facebook group. Like over 14,000 entrepreneurs are in this Facebook group. And it's a really valuable Facebook group. I use it a lot. And a woman named Lindsay had posted about a problem I knew I could help her with. She had said that she's like, I have a course that's spinning around inside my head and I know people need it and I know my exact niche, but I can't get it out of my head. What advice do you have? Now, for a few years, I've known that one of my magical powers is to pull people's ideas out of their heads and make confusion into sense. I've done it with my friends and my colleagues and students. Basically, we work together to turn the soup inside their minds into a roadmap that they can follow with ease. And I've been doing it for free because I didn't think anyone would pay for it. Because again, it was so easy for me and it was fun. Why would anybody pay me, right? So I sent this woman a message just offering to sit with her and pull it all out of her head for free. And I'll be honest, it was a selfish give. I wanted to see if I really could do this on a totally cold topic that I had no experience with someone that I had zero personal contact or context with, so that I just could I really just drop in and do this? I'm going to fast forward you to the answer. Yes, I sure as hell could do that. And according to this woman, Lindsay, our time together was, quote unquote, incredibly helpful. And so I asked her, you know, what would you have paid for a service like this? And she said, I have to admit, I'm cheap. I never would have paid for this. But you were really useful and I'd never have gotten this out into the world so quickly unless it was for you. And I was like, what? Literally, she just admitted she would never have paid for it. She would have kept spinning around and around taking everybody's advice, even though she wanted to get it out into the world and she knew she couldn't on her own. And so I said, okay, well, if you had paid for it, what value would you put on it? And she said, $200. And I was just really pissed in that moment, really friggin' pissed. I was like, no, she did not just say $200. And in that moment, that pissed offedness, I knew from how pissed I was that I knew my value. And that moment, I knew I would never give it away for free again. Because I realized she had no clue what she had just gotten. That in 2 hours, she had her entire course out of her head, down on paper with notes I took for her, created a roadmap so she can put it out into the world, and she could start charging her clients for it in 2 hours. And in that moment, I knew I'd never give it away for free again. So if you, like me, have not trusted yourself, If you have thought, everyone can do what I do, this is no big deal, I don't really deserve to get paid for it. If you've been terrified to start charging big money for what you do, please remember this story of me on the phone with Lindsay, testing out whether I brought value, because I sure as hell did, and she just didn't value it. Over the past 2 years, I've done a lot of personal work to decide that growing a business can be easier than I've ever dreamed, and that my magical abilities actually deserve to be compensated. And you deserve that too. Have you learned how to trust yourself yet to value your superpowers? If you've been wondering if the thing that you love doing, that thing that feels as easy as breathing to you, is really valuable, trust yourself, my friend. It is. This week, spend some time thinking about that thing you love doing, the thing that you've talked yourself into thinking everyone else can do this. They can't. If it's easy for you, I assure you, there's many people out there who it's not easy for. Serve those people. And if they don't want to pay for it, then they're not your ideal client. You don't have to bend over backwards to serve people who don't want to pay for the value that you bring. And if you're tired of your ideas spinning around in your head, let's talk. I have 2 or 3 limited options for working together this summer. And if you're really ready to invest in yourself, let's talk about how working together would move you along faster. Imagine how one session could really just get you out of your own way. If you go to my website, www.jenliddy.com, you'll see a button there. And right at that button, we can talk about how to work together and whether we're a good fit. Thank you for listening all the way through. I want to encourage you to think about that thing you love doing and put some value to it and take action on that today. I'll see you next week. Bye-bye. Thanks for joining me today. If you like what you heard, please subscribe to the Idea Space in your podcast app and tell that friend of yours who needs some help getting where she wants to go. I'd be so appreciative if you left a review, because then we can help more women create the space for their ideas too. Go to jenliddy.com/free to grab the many free resources there to help you move forward. And I will see you next time. Bye.